Eco-sensitive tourism tackles the issue of sustaining an environmentally and culturally responsible tourism and focuses on experiencing natural areas in ways that result in its understanding and appreciation. Just on the outskirts of Manali town, there lies Humta, which is one of the most visited trekking destinations in India. It lies near a heritage village, Preeni, which is also known as the late Prime Minister Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee's village. Humta is one of the most pristine sites of Himachal Pradesh, which is located in Manali of District Kullu, Himachal Pradesh. It lies on the Pir Panjal range of the Himalayas and is blessed with dense, lush green tree canopies of deodar, kale and rhododendron. The place is surrounded with magnificent snow-capped mountains which have enriched flora and fauna. Humta Pass starts from Manali to Jobra, which is the base camp of Humta, by following the landmarks of Preeni, Sethan and Manduroba on the way.
It's a beautiful place, I'm loving it, and especially the mountains here. Coming from city life, like living all my life in city and coming to the mountains, it just makes me feel so good.
The site has majestic waterfalls and water bodies blended with scenic beauty like the Shalay Waterfall, Panduroba, Tuna Waterfall and Chika Waterfall. There are some numerous notable mammals found in the Indar Kila National Park, such as Gaurav, the Himalayan Black Bear, the Himalayan Brown Bear, Himalayan Red Fox and Musk Deer. The Himachal Pradesh Forest Department has been attempting to engage the communities in conservation of the area by providing livelihood opportunities to them.
Humta presents a classic case of very high footfall in the name of ecotourism. So this was the first case when we came up with this idea of ecological sensitive tourism, in which community runs the show instead of acting as a mule jockeys, cooks or as a drivers. And they do this in a very participatory mode with the forest department and ensure that ecological regeneration happens on these sites and regulations are observed.
GIZ, in collaboration with the Himachal Pradesh Forest Department, is implementing the Himachal Pradesh Forest Ecosystem Services Project since 2016. This project is funded by the German Federal Ministry for Economic Cooperation and Development, or BMZ. When the project approached the site, there was no need of upscaling the eco-sensitive tourism potential. It already had high camping pressure and unsustainable trekking footfall. Most of the young adults were either migrated to cities or engaged in small-scale income generation activities. Most houses were also leased out as hotels to outside traders, and trekking trade business also had less local level ownership. Permanent trekking camps led to degradation of the site with poor regeneration. In a nutshell, it was a case of tourism exploitation without an ecologically sensitive tourism. During initial rounds of discussion, communities expressed their concern about degradation of the site and lack of proper management plan to manage ecotourism activities. They shared the need to build capacities of the local youth and women for managing ecotourism activities with an agenda of proper ecological balance, regulation on footfalls, participatory monitoring and management of forest resources with the Forest Department. There are some major activities that the project is focusing on strengthening the capacities of local communities, such as managing and operating homestays, acknowledging women as the core workforce for eco-sensitive tourism, specific trainings like homestays and cooking with local customs, ethnic food prepared using local agriculture diversity and hospitality at its core were organized.
We give specialized training so that they can make maximum benefit of their places. They can also encourage more tourists coming in. They can get involvement in the tourist activity, as well as the tourists who are coming are actually, they feel good They feel hospitable. इस ट्रेनिंग से काफ़ी चीज़ें नई सीखने को मिली हैं, कैसे हमें जो है अपने गेस्ट को वेलकम करना है, रिसीव करना है, कैसे हमें उनके साथ ट्रीट करना है, जैसे मतलब ज़्यादा उनके साथ गुस्से से बात भी नहीं करनी है, अच्छे से बात करनी है, फ्रेंडली रहना है.
Project is strengthening the capacities of local communities to establish cross-cultural and traditional experiences by managing homestays sustainably along with relishing local cuisines. Eco-sensitive tourism, accommodating units at village level, provide additional income sources to the family members by associating them to visitor management.
जैसे फूड को प्रेजेंट कैसे करना है, जो फूड है कैसे बनाते हैं, जैसे चाइनीज़ कैसे बनाते हैं, वो हमने सीखा.
सो नॉट ओनली आर दे एक्चुअली केटरिंग टू नेशनल टूरिस्ट, दे आल्सो केटरिंग टू इंटरनेशनल टूरिस्ट.
ट्रैकिंग एंड कैंपिंग आर वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट टूरिज्म एक्टिविटीज ऑफ द प्लेस. पीपल एंजॉय एनालाइजिंग डिफरेंट सेक्शंस ऑफ द ट्रैक्स, types of forests and the proximity of the mountain views. The major treks of the place are the Humta Pass Trek, Kansar Thatch Trek, Marasu Thatch Trek, Hanasu Thatch Trek, Humta Circle Trek, Indarkila Base Camp Trek, Diotibba Base Camp Trek and Farkunda Peak Trek. Nurtured by centuries of tradition, the people of Humta celebrate and host some local fairs and festivals to honor the local deity of the place. Traditional food is a significant attraction for rural travel destinations. Local food is a fundamental component of a destination's attributes, adding to the range of attractions and the overall tourist experience.
We came here and I have eaten proper home-cooked Himachali food.
We were fortunate enough to get to try ziplining. So, what did you think of it?
Driving, off-roading through the mountains, but I was ziplining and that's like feeling the wind in a whole different way. It was just amazing.